That's fantastic. The golden rule, treat others as you wish to be treated. Awesome. Another example of what compassion means. Tell me your name. Is it Landon?
London.
London. Okay? Yes, it means to have respect for other people and to be kind to them. James? Yes, to feel what they feel. If they're feeling sad, then make them feel better and to honor them. That's really good. So the main difference, you guys can thank you for volunteering. The main difference between kindness and compassion is just that kindness is something, an act you're doing for somebody that's nice, but you're not necessarily thinking about their feelings and how it makes them feel. Whereas compassion is you're really trying to feel what that other person is feeling, and it helps you understand how you can help them a little bit better. So we're looking for both things at Basalt Middle School. We want you to be kind, do nice things for people, but we also want you to be compassionate and think about what other people are feeling and what you can do to help them feel better. So, do you know what our school motto is?
No.
Okay. Oh, a couple people think they know. Our goal is for you to remember and practice and commit to the school motto, to learn about and remember and commit to the expectations. Expect, same as you were learning at the elementary school, there are expectations at our school too. And then I want to share some books with you that I read this summer because I'm just really excited that we have time in the day to read now. And then I'll have you talk a little bit about how you're going to grow, and we'll send you off to specials. So this is our school motto. Is that what you were going to say, those of you who are raising your hand?
Yeah.
All right, let's say it together. Ready? Work hard, be kind, achieve. You're going to breeze through middle school if you're doing these things. If you work hard and you're kind, the teachers are here to help you with anything you need, then you're going to achieve, okay? Sometimes we work hard, but we don't have the help we need, and it still is hard to learn. So make sure you're asking questions and doing everything you can to pour yourself into your learning, and we will do, I promise, everything we can to help you with your learning. I know your teachers really well, and they really, they thought all summer about what they want for you this year, and they're going to make it the best. So talking about perseverance, which is one of our habits, is tied to the growth mindset. Do you know what growth mindset means? What does growth mindset mean? And tell me your name again. Yes. Leela. What does growth mindset mean?
Growth mindset is that you're able to learn more things.
tripping over a bunch of rocks because that was a well-worn path. A lot of people came on that path before me to lay it down, and it wasn't stressful to try to get past it. But when we learn something new, so think about learning something new as like a forest with no path in it. Can you picture that? There's no path, so when I'm trying to learn something new, I'm kind of struggling a little bit, yeah? That's a yellow lab. When I'm trying to learn something new, I'm struggling a little bit. And as I struggle, I get a little bit better and the struggle's a little less. And then if I keep trying, it gets a little bit easier and the struggle's a little bit less. And that's what that path reminded me of. The more we go down that path and practice and do the same thing over and over and over again, the easier it is to do that thing. So can you think, I'm thinking of like a math skill, because sometimes that's what takes a lot of practice. And it does get easier over time. You might not have been able to do certain things when you started elementary, and now they feel easy to you because you practiced. So I'm going to encourage you to commit to do your very best work every single time, to practice so that you have, and picture like this well-worn path. When you practice, it'll get easier. And then why do you think friends is up there? What do you think, Sylvie? Okay, so people who aren't going to talk to you too much when you're in class, because that might get in the way of your learning. What else? Is that Tanner? I can't see who's under the hat. Who is it?
Harrison.
Okay, Harrison. Yeah, your friends can help you through things sometimes when you're having trouble. So yeah, friends are up there. Like, okay, so I like to ride my bike a lot. And if I'm riding up a hill, and it's a really hard hill, if I'm saying to myself, I can't do it, I just can't do it, it's gonna be so hard, I fell off my bike last time, do you think I'm gonna make it up the hill? No. If the person in front of me gets off their bike and doesn't try or feels like, oh, here's that hill that's coming up, it's so hard, do you think that's gonna help me make it up that hill? No. But if I'm riding behind somebody else and they're just going over everything and making it look easy for me, then I'm saying to myself, okay, it always looks harder than it looks. It's always easier than it looks. That's what I say to myself. I just need to try, and I see them do it, so I believe I can. So being that kind of a friend, that you encourage others, and you're staying positive, and then they're more able to stay positive. So taking on the leadership, and when you're feeling down, asking somebody else to bring you up. You be the follower then. And when you're feeling like, ooh, I see people around me struggling, they might need me to help, then be that person. I was so proud of the eighth graders today. There was a kid who's new to our school. He was online last year, and he was sitting by himself at lunch. And I was talking to him, and pretty soon, two different groups of eighth graders came up and introduced themselves. The second group said, hey, you want to come sit with us? And they hung out with him all lunch, and I was like, oh, I love you guys. Because that's the kind of way, that's how that student now is going to feel like he can come to school. They helped him with that, creating that path. So remember, your habits are going to make things easier or harder, depending on what you set as your habit. When you commit to something, it's a lot easier to get it done. You push yourself through it a lot easier. Practice counts. That's how you make the path. Practice, 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 and pretty soon you're not getting caught up anymore as you try to go through. And then finally, your friends, they make a big difference. So these are our expectations. Do you notice anything up there that's different? It says expect. Did you learn it that way last year?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, it should be the same. I put some different words in there to kind of help remind you what those things are. So there's a lot of research behind these five character skills. And even people who struggle with the learning in school are very successful if they can master these five habits. Practicing your executive skills, making goals for yourself, staying organized, using self-control when you're like, oh, I don't really want to do this right now. instead, and you say to yourself, ugh, is that going to help me get what I need? How about I do this first and then I'll go watch some TV? Perseverance, we talked about. Enthusiasm. Who can read? Why don't you all read those three words that I have up there for enthusiasm? Ownership, questioning, attitude. That's how you show enthusiasm. You ask good questions. Ownership means, like, I know this is my learning, and no matter what everybody around me is saying to me, it's really about me. So even if the grown-ups are saying, do this, you're not thinking about them. You're thinking about, I'm going to do this because I know it's what I need, and you're trying to learn as much as you can. We talked about compassion and then teamwork. Compromise, what does that word mean? In the back, what's your name? Yep. Daniel. What does compromise mean? Did you say help from another person? And then what was the second part? Kind of. Compromise is more like, okay, so I'm having a conversation with another person and they want things this way. Say I'm on a team with Theo, and he really thinks that we should do a slideshow, and I really think that we should make a video, and we're like not agreeing. Compromise means that one of us kind of says, okay, why don't we, you know, do a slideshow and put it in a video, and we both are giving something up. Or I just say, you know what, I like the idea of a slideshow, maybe we'll do a video this time, and I let go of my idea so he can do his. That's compromise. Not always having to have your own way. And it's really important when you're working in a team, because you're not always going to get your own way. It's like we all are so different. Every single person in the entire world is so different, and we all want different things. So being able to listen to somebody and give up your idea so they can have theirs takes a lot of character. And then all voices, there are some times that some people dominate the conversation. They take over, and other people don't get to speak. And other people just kind of stand back and they never say anything because they just feel shy. So making sure that anytime you're working together that everybody gets a chance to have their voice heard. If you're the one who likes to talk a lot, you kind of stop for a minute and ask for somebody else's idea. And if you're the one who feels really shy, you push yourself to say something. And then sometimes you're the listener and sometimes you're the leader. So these habits are really important. The most important thing, really. We get to talk about deer. This summer, I just finished this book yesterday, and that one's a grown-up book. This was my son's favorite series called Ranger's Apprentice, and I think he started it in fifth grade. It's kind of hard, but I have this book on my bookstand. I'm going to start reading it next. And this one is about the first black district forester working for the Forest Service. And so I'm almost done reading that book, and it's been very interesting about how she made her goals. These are books that a friend recommended. Both of them are really good, about kind of a kid who's had a really hard life and he's 13 years old. So that might be better in the next couple years, but you might want to read it now. And you can ask me questions about these later if you want. And then these, I read this one when I taught fifth grade a long time ago, but I reread it this summer and read this and this. So I'm ready for book four, but I haven't read it yet. That's about kids who find out that they are time travelers. And I won't tell you more because I want it to be a surprise. But I really encourage you to find a good book to talk to each other about the books that you're reading. James. Our library has some of these books, and whatever books we don't have, Ms. Douglas loves to buy new books for our school, plus the Salt Regional Library has a lot of them too. Most of them I checked out from the library and sometimes through Audible so I could listen to them. Yes, Harrison. Yes, please bring your own books. Read wherever, from wherever you want, but you should have a book to read every single day as soon as you get here. Just have it in your backpack so you can jump right into reading. Okay, so my last question for you is, how are you going to grow this year? It's a big year for fifth graders transitioning. I'm sure you're already growing. Did you feel like your brain was going to explode trying to figure out how to open your locker? It's a big, big challenge. And it takes a lot of practice, doesn't it? And some people people are doing a good job of asking for help, and some are helping others. For some of you, it just came easy. Maybe that's not your big challenge this year. You have to just decide what's going to challenge me, and what am I going to do to meet that goal. So right now, I want you to turn and talk to somebody about what's something that you think might be a little hard for you that you're going to push yourself on this year, and how are you going to grow? Turn and talk.
Working on.